back to the Hey Chanté kitchen. I'm Hey Chanté, and today I'm going to be cooking barbecue chicken drumsticks and Brussels sprouts with mushrooms. And the topic that we're going to be talking about today is middle school crushes and how I crushed at crushing. So normally I make this recipe with chicken thighs, but ever since I saw a tweet on Twitter that said chicken thighs are better than chicken breasts, which is like obviously duh, I haven't been able to find chicken thighs in my grocery store, which really, really pisses me off because I see 1,000 million tons of chicken breasts, but never any chicken thighs. And it really makes me mad because chicken breasts are gross, they're dry, they're thick and they're tough. You have to put a bunch of seasoning on it, and even if after you put a bunch of seasoning on it, it still tastes gross. So you have to dunk it in barbecue sauce, hot sauce, honey mustard sauce, ranch dressing, blue dressing, anything, just to break it down so you can be able to chew and swallow without choking. So it really makes me mad for whoever made chicken thighs super popular because it fucking limits me being able to cook my recipes the way that I like to. But anyway, besides that, let's get started. So I've already washed my chicken and I washed my vegetables. I feel like not a lot of people know that they need to be washing their meats, their poultries, and their vegetables. Just because it's in a package doesn't mean that the person who put the chicken in the package washed it ahead of time. The person could have dropped the chicken on the floor and then put it back in the package. Just because you're at the produce section and you see the sprinklers on doesn't mean that they're washing the vegetables. Somebody could have came by and sneezed on it right before you came in to put your Brussels sprouts in your bag. Wash your vegetables, wash your meat. So, that being said, let's just tell you what the ingredients I'm cooking with for today. Barbecue sauce. I always, always make my own barbecue sauce. By making it, I mean like I jazz it up a little bit. I put more ingredients than just the generic bottle. So it doesn't really matter what barbecue sauce you get. This is Kroger's thick and spicy. You can get whatever barbecue sauce you'd like. I'm going to be using local Hive honey. I just like raw and unfiltered honey. It just tastes better and it's a lot better for you. Black pepper, garlic powder, onion powder, ground red pepper, and of course, Lawry seasoning salt. I'm also going to be using brown sugar, olive oil, and thyme. Cool, so let's get started. So, the topic that I wanted to talk about was crushes. I was thinking about life in middle school yesterday, and so I was like, oh, it'd be cute to just like romanticize the past like I always do. I'm a nostalgic addict. And I was thinking about this one time I had this crush on this boy, and we'll call him, for privacy's sake, we'll call him Alan. Now, thinking back on it, he was not that cute, and he always had crusts in his eyes, and I don't think he ever brushed his teeth a day in his life, but for whatever reason, that, like, lured me in, and I was in love with this kid. And so, as always, people are always in, like, your middle school relationships. I had to wait my turn, because he was going out with somebody at the time. But for me, when I like somebody, like, I really, really like them, and I'm, like, hooked onto them, and, like, they're the only, like, person I think about, like, I don't think about anybody else, so.
I believe in love at first sight, but love is tricky.
Like a dummy, I waited and took, like, waited my turn until Alan was mine, and so, like, it was cute, but, like, I wasn't allowed to date. Like, what is middle school? 11, 12? There's no way I was allowed to have a boyfriend. I wasn't allowed to do anything, let alone be interested in boys or, like, have boys call the house or, like, go anywhere with boys. I'm going to set this stuff to the side because right now I'm going to be seasoning my chicken. I love a good seasoned chicken. I don't understand why people wouldn't want to season chicken and have flavor in their meals. So I season my chicken and I season my barbecue sauce because seasoning is life. I season both sides too because I just appreciate flavor. So anyway, crushes, middle school. So as most of you guys know about me, I'm like obsessed with Britney Spears. Britney Spears is my queen. I've loved her since the day that she's come out. Yes, I've lost friendships over battling on, like, who's better, Christina Aguilera or Britney Spears, knowing damn well Christina can sing way better than Britney, but, like, Britney had that it factor. She was, like, that sweet, innocent baby kid, and I just was, like, I felt like I identified with her so much better than any of the other pop stars that was out. So I loved Britney Spears. And so I was trying really, 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 really hard to get this Allen kid to notice me. Is it just me, or is, like, ground pepper always, like, clog up the rims? Like, no matter, this is a brand new bottle. Like, no matter how fresh the bottle is, it always gets clogged. And you always have to shake the shit out of it. So now I'm gonna season the other side, flip it over. So anyway, so I was like, how am I gonna get this kid to notice me? I really like him. I don't know why I liked him though. He wasn't funny. He wasn't smart. He wasn't charismatic. I think it's just because he was just like a blonde, blue-eyed boy. And I was really into like Jonathan Taylor Thomas and like Leonardo DiCaprio and all those like blonde, blue-eyed white boys back in the day. And so I think that's probably why I had such a crush on this Allen kid. But anyway, so my big idea was, oh, I'm gonna write this kid a poem and I'm gonna get him to notice me through my words. And so I sat down, oh, I forgot the Lawry. I only put the Lawry seasoning salt on one side of the meat, the chicken, because it's salt. And if you put too much salt on stuff, you know, that's bad for your health. You can get high blood pressure. I'm sure it's not good for diabetes, but it will make the food just too salty and that just will ruin all the flavor. So I'm gonna go ahead and put it on this side of the chicken since I didn't put it on the other one. But anyway, so I was like, I'm gonna get him to notice me. I'm gonna write him a poem. Cause I was a pretty good writer in my, God damn it, this pepper. For middle schooler, I always got A's on English when we had to write like haikus. You guys remember haikus? And things like that. So I was like, of course, he'll love me. Jesus Christ, he will love me after he sees my poem. But like, I sat and I sat and I sat and I couldn't think of like a good poem to write this kid. Like I wrote so many different poems, but like none of them seemed to fit. And so I was listening to my Britney Spears cassette tape. Her first one, Hit Me Baby One More Time, and I was listening to Born to Make You Happy. Do you guys remember that song? So I got the great idea, like, oh, he'll never know this one because it's on a single, it's off the album. I'm sure Allen doesn't listen to Britney Spears on a regular basis. He'll never know if I take these song lyrics, write them down, and pass them off as my own. It'll be a great idea. So that's what I did. I opened up the cassette, I unfolded the pictures and the lyrics. Remember when CDs and cassette tapes used to have the lyrics so that you can sing along? Oh, one thing. So, to make sure that, like, the chicken, I'm gonna bake these, the chicken isn't dried out, I like to add olive oil to it to make it more moist. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. Whew, I'm so hot. I'm losing my breath. So anyway, and I do like to rub it in. Making food and making chicken especially, I like to get my hands dirty. I like to feel my food. I like to know what's going on. I'm not afraid to get a little dirty. So I like to massage the seasoning and the oil into the chicken. Just make sure that it just gets all moist and like feels really good. I lost my place in my story. So I wrote the lyrics down on a piece of computer paper, you know, the kind that you had to like peel off the perforated, do you remember? It was like folded and it came out like what is that thing that Urkel uses? What is that called? The thing that Urkel used. Whatever. I put it on a piece of paper, goddammit. And I wrote it and I gave it to him because at this time he had broken up with, God, I want to say her name. Was her name Heather? Chris, Chelsea, Michaela, Teresa, something. I don't know. One of those names. He had finally broken up with her and I was like, oh my gosh, like it's time like to go in for the kill. Like it's now or never. If I don't give him this note, then some other Becky's going to run up on him and they're going to date for 2 months and then I have to leave again because obviously it's middle school. No one stays together forever in middle school. And if you did, sorry about it. So anyway, so I give him this note and I'm like, he's never going to know it's not mine. It's going to be great. So now I'm going to, I have the seasoning on the chicken. So now I'm going to bake the chicken wings for 15 minutes while I cook the sauce or get the sauce going at least. And then I'm going to start on the Brussels sprouts and mushrooms. So we're going to put this in my preheated oven. I put my oven on 375. That's just what I usually put my ovens on if there's no recipe. So now let's move on to the Brussels sprouts. I foiled my pans always because it's just easier to wash and easier to clean up. Just take the foil off and throw it away. So anyway, it's like my catchphrase. I say so anyway all the time. So I give this note to Alan and I think I like slipped it in his locker or like dropped it off on his desk real smooth like and ran away. Cause it's middle school and I'm like 11, I'm 12. I don't, you know how to really talk to boys. And I don't hear anything else about it, right? So the day's like going on. We're almost, he and I are like in every class together because the way that my middle school was set up, it was like A, B, C team. And if you're on A team, you pretty much have all the same classes with everybody who is in the A team, including homeroom. So with my Brussels sprouts, you guys, this is how I like to make them. I like to roast them. Roasting them is super easy. So I use olive oil and I drench it all over. Get it real olive oily. My worst fear is having dry food. I feel like having dry food completely ruins the whole eating experience. It's just a bad vibe. Having to see somebody, you present somebody some food and they're like, oh man, pass the ketchup or pass the sriracha. It's just like, oh no, you failed because your food was too dry and now they need to cover it up with some sauce. So I like to make sure that I have a lot of moisture going into my foods. So anyway, I'm gonna take, I like spicy food, so I'm gonna put a little red pepper on it. Just a little bit. I don't need it to be too spicy because the chicken and barbecue chicken is going to be spicy enough, but I just like to have the hints of flavor. Onion powder. I didn't feel like chopping onions today, so that's why I'm using onion powder as well as garlic powder. I feel like having my fingers smell like garlic all day, so I'm just using the onion powder. And I always use black pepper. Black pepper is one of my favorite seasonings. It just tastes good. It tastes homey. It just makes everything taste really good. A little bit of that on there. And I'm gonna use some thyme too. I don't really cook with thyme all that much. But it's in my kitchen now, so I'm gonna give it a try. Seasoning is expensive, so I don't want to be wasteful. I just have it sit up there. Did you know seasoning goes bad? A lot of people think just because seasoning is dry, that means it will last forever. That's not true. Some seasoning, depending on, you know, the price that you pay for it or where you got it from or how long you've had it, the potency of the flavor starts to wear out and I guess evaporate. I'm not exactly sure what the process of it is, but it does lose its intensity and its potency. I'm gonna get a little bit of regular salt too, just a tad bit to bring up the flavor just a little bit more. Just a little bit. It wasn't a lot. I'm not salty. But anyway, and then again, I'm gonna use my fingers to manipulate the seasoning, massage it into my vegetables. I love the feeling of food. I don't know why. I always like to like eat with my hands. I don't do it often in public because, you know, it's not courteous. But if I could, I would just eat everything with my fingers. My grandpa used to call it being a savage.
Savages?
So you don't do that because we're not savages. So I give this letter to Alan, I think is what I named him. And I'm like waiting all day, like, hello, like, did you read my letter? Did you find it? I can't remember. I think I put it in his locker. I can't remember. But anyway, so lunchtime finally like rolls around, right? And everybody at the table, we pretty much all sat in the same table because you know, once you had to sit with your class. And I come over, you know, with my tray, and I'm just like so stressed out because like I see Alan over there at the table, but he's not talking to me, but like everybody is laughing. And I'm like, what is so funny? Because I've been around everybody all day, I have no idea. Putting this in the oven to roast for 45 minutes. So I'm like, what's so funny? Gets the table, this girl who, she ends up being my best friend for the rest of middle school, and we'll call her Ramona. So Ramona has a piece of paper in her hand, and I'm like, okay, whatever, you know, a piece of paper, we're at school, like maybe they're playing the fortune cookie teller game, whatever, I don't care. So I sit down at my table, and everybody keeps laughing, and so finally I'm like, what's so funny? And Ramona is like, Chanté. And I'm like, yes? Have you heard of the song Born to Make You Happy by Britney Spears? And I'm like, you know, shit. And I'm like, no. How does that go? Like, sing it to me. Because I'm embarrassed, like I'm bound out. And so she begins to read the lyrics off the paper. And she's like, have you heard of this song? And I was like, come to think of it, yeah, it kind of rings a bell just a little bit. And she's like, did you tell or did you give this to Alan or something like that? And I was like, no, why would I do that? Because I don't know, I can't remember if I signed my name to it or not. I think I did because I'm a boss ass bitch, ain't afraid of shit, but I don't remember. But probably so, because everybody was like laughing and looking at me, and she was like, Chanté, do you know this? And so like my ass is on the line. And so she was making fun of me because I pretended to write this poem when it was really a Britney Spears song. But of course the girls would know it was a Britney Spears song. We love Britney Spears down. She was our queen. But so that was like really embarrassing for me. But it worked. Ooh, Alan and I, we dated for, what, 2 weeks, which is like 2 months in middle school years. It was really bad. Like I said earlier, I'm not allowed to date, so I couldn't like go anywhere with him. So it was just me talking to him on the phone, but like I couldn't really talk to him on the phone because I couldn't have boys call the cows. So my friend, we'll call her Lisa. Lisa would call me, and then we would call him on three-way so that I wouldn't get in trouble for having boys call the house. And so it was just really stupid. And then we didn't live too far from each other. So like I lived behind this huge field. At the end of the field, there was this pond, and then he lived across the pond, across the street. So he would ride his bike. I was like, oh, I'm going to the pond. I'm just going for a walk. And so he would ride his bike down to the pond, and then we would just sit there and stare at each other because I never had a boyfriend before, so I didn't know what you were supposed to do with a boyfriend. And so we would just sit there for what seemed like an hour, and then we'd be like, all right, gotta go. This was fun. So yeah, so that's how I got my high school or my middle school crush. So this is what I'm doing right now, is I'm preparing the sauce for my chicken. I am just emptying who I really, really, really love barbecue sauce. You guys like barbecue. I'm from the Midwest, and we are like barbecue city over where I'm from. Missouri, Kansas, Nebraska, that whole area, we're just like barbecue, barbecue, barbecue. And so I really like my barbecue chicken messy and sloppy and just full of flavor. So I'm using 2 bottles of barbecue sauce. And again, like I said earlier, it does not matter which brand of barbecue sauce you're going to use because we're going to season this puppy up. So as a child, I was always taught waste not, want not, so I put a little bit of water into the bottle, shake it to get all that thick sauce around the sides. You see how it's starting to fall down? And then we empty it in there. And it's not gross because water is not bad for you. Water is actually really good for you. And people don't drink enough water, and that's why you smell that way. Okay, so again, I don't really use a recipe. I do everything like by taste and by sight. Is it still recording? Cool. By taste and by sight. So I'm going to add some brown sugar into this mix. It's gonna be like a sweet, spicy barbecue sauce. That's how I like it. So I'm just gonna look at it and see how much barbecue brown sugar I want in my sauce. That looks like it's enough. If it's not, I'll come back. You always want to taste as you go when you're cooking because heat changes everything. Heat changes the consistency of things and heat changes the flavor of the things. So sometimes you've cooked out all of your brown sugar, sometimes you've cooked out all your seasoning and you need to put it back in. Gonna add some honey. You don't really need a lot of honey, it depends on your taste buds. I like semi a lot, semi not. Again, black pepper. Garlic powder, always. I never, don't ever not cook with garlic powder, onion powder, and black pepper. Those will always be in anything I cook. Either I'm cooking hamburgers, chicken, duck, chitlins, whatever, those are always gonna be my main ingredients. That was the onion powder. Again, we're gonna make a spicy barbecue sauce. We're gonna put some red pepper into it. Since this is giving me fever, I'm just gonna open it from the lid and just knock it back. Cool, that's gonna be really good. Cool, and then some more Lawry seasoning salt. Just a little bit of the salt to bring it all together. Alright, so I have put the sauce on the stove at a medium to low temperature. Probably low because I'm not going to be paying attention to it all that much right now while the food is cooking. I'm going to stir the ingredients inside and then put the lid on it and just let it cook slowly. You really have to watch out for sugary sauces because sugar heats up very, very quickly and will heat up anything really quickly around it too. And so you want to make sure that you watch anything that has sugar in it because it will cook so quickly that it will burn and stick to the bottom of your pans, and you don't want that to happen. Cool, and I'm just gonna let that simmer on low. Awesome. So now I've got my chicken in the oven. I've got my broccoli. I've got my chicken in the oven. I've got my Brussels sprouts and mushrooms in the oven, and they're going to cook for a little bit. I set my chicken at a 15-minute timer because it's going to bake for a little bit, and then we're going to start coating it with the barbecue sauce. So while that's happening, I'm just going to clean up. Okay, so now I've taken the chicken out of the oven. Obviously, it's not cooked. If you think 15 minutes is enough time to cook chicken, you need not to be cooking chicken.
I went to the microwave, put the chicken in, and there was a button that said, chicken.
Chicken should not be pink in the center. The reason why I took it out of the oven is because I want to put the sauce on it. So I have my barbecue brush. It's a pastry brush, but it's just easier to brush on the sauce rather than having to like dunk it. So anyway, so the moral of the story of having crushes, just try to be your authentic self. I was trying to be sneaky and trying to impress this guy with words of Britney Spears, and it would have worked had Ramona's hating ass not come out and confronted me that way. But, you know, I guess that's what I get for trying to be fake about it. I should have just told him my true emotion and written him my own sincere poem. But, like, it was middle school. Like, you live and you learn. And middle school is tough as it is. Like, I remember in middle school when 9/11 happened. That was the day that I got my first period. Another menstruation conversation. It was on the same exact day. It was so ridiculous. I was like, everybody's worried about these planes, and I'm over here worried about my underwear being soaked and ruined in the middle of class. I guess I got my period a lot in class, and I was never prepared. So, that doesn't happen to me anymore, thankfully. So I painted the sauce on the chicken. I'm gonna put it back in for another 15-20 minutes. And then see what happens after that. The vegetables need to roast for like 45 minutes, so those are good. And I keep my eye on them anyway. So cool. So see you in a minute. Okay, so it's been 45 minutes since we put in the Brussels sprouts and mushrooms. We're gonna pull those out and check on them. They should be roasted. Yes, 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 yes. I don't know if you can see that, but it's crispy and it's hot. So we're gonna pull the chicken out. I'm gonna test it to see how much more time it needs in that oven. Okay. Oh, it smells so good. I like a little bit more sauce on my chicken, because I told you earlier, like, it's saucy, barbecue sauce. Barbecue sauce is supposed to be messy and gay. You're not supposed to look cute when you're eating barbecue sauce. Barbecue sauce is supposed to be all over your mouth, all over your face, all over your chin, all over your nose. It's supposed to dribble down on your shirt. It's supposed to get underneath your fingernails. It's supposed to be a mess. And then, you're supposed to lick your fingers to get the sauce off, okay? Wet wipes are not for getting the sauce off. Wet wipes are for the cleanup after you've already done your tongue's work, okay? So here's the meat thermometer. So really quick, it's really important when you cook, when you use a meat thermometer, to not stick the thermometer to the bone. The bone is going to have more heat in it, and it's not going to give you an accurate reading if the meat is cooked through, okay? So we want to make sure that we're not touching the bone with the meat thermometer. So let's look at the thickest piece, which is right here. I'm going to shove that in that baby. It's not near the bone at all, it's only in the meat. And just like I thought, the meat's not cooked yet, which is great, which means we can add more sauce to the chicken and put it back in and cook. It's gonna be so delicious. I have something in my eye, but we will be right back, okay? Okay, so we've pulled the chicken out of the oven for the third time, and now I'm going to check to see if it's fully cooked with my handy dandy meat thermometer.
Many minutes later.
And it's absolutely finished, which is awesome. But I want to add just the last little layer of barbecue sauce because I want these to be sticky and messy.
Oh! Oh, kill him! Oh, kill him! Oh!
Gosh, these chicken wings look so good, you guys. I'm gonna take a picture. Look at these. Can I bring it closer? Look at this. Can you see? Is it gonna... Can you guys see? What if I just dropped it all right now? I'd be so mad. Rinse it off and eat it. I'm just kidding. Cool, and so that's it, you guys. Thanks for coming over to the Hey Chanté kitchen with me, Hey Chanté, cooking barbecue drumsticks and Brussels sprouts with mushrooms. I hope you guys enjoyed my story. I know it was kind of off the wall, like, what is she talking about? I don't know, you guys. I do this for myself. I don't do this for you. I entertain myself, but I had a good time. So, yeah, if you guys want to see another video, comment below and tell me what you want me to cook. I probably won't do it because I listen to myself and only myself. But let me know if you enjoyed this video. I don't know which side of the box the subscription box is on. So find that subscription box and subscribe. Use that little arrow to share. Comment below. You can find me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook at Hey Chanté Hey. And yeah, so I'll see you guys next week or whenever I feel like it. Bye.
And if you don't dip your bread in the leftover barbecue sauce, you have a bad year. Bread and barbecue sauce. Enjoy.